I welcome all the learners to this video lecture on the topic use of ICT tools for preparing tests and analyzing results. Friends, in the last 2-3 videos we have extensively discussed about what is assessment and how technology or ICTs can be used for assessing the progress of the children. In this video lecture we'll be discussing about couple of ICT tools which you can use in the teaching learning processes. I'll be demonstrating how these tools can be used for developing various tests and examinations. We'll also see how the test results are analyzed using one of the very latest and popular techniques, which is the learning analytics. So we will discuss about 2-3 tools. We will see the demonstration of how these tools are used for preparing tests and examinations. And at the end of this video lecture, we'll be talking about learning analytics. With this, I once again welcome all the learners to this video lecture. Friends, to start with, I would request you to recall about at what all stages we do the assessment. There are 3 stages. One in the beginning of the session, which is just conducted before the teaching session. This is a kind of a diagnostic assessment or evaluation where the teacher would assess the level of the learner. What is their understanding about the subject concept they are going to learn in the classroom? So this is done in the classroom before the teaching session. The second is during the teaching session, when a teacher discusses or teaches a particular concept or the subject, whether the students are following what the teacher is teaching in the classroom. This is done during the teaching session. Then at the end of the teaching session, whether the students have understood the concept or the subject that was discussed in the classroom, teacher will do a summative kind of assessment. So this is done at the end of the teaching session. So there are 3 stages: one before the teaching session, second during the session, and third after completing the teaching session. Now friends, talking about the technologies, again I would request you to recall the previous sessions where we have pointed out, shown you number of ICT tools. Many of these tools are very popular that way. We have also discussed about the Google tool, which is the Google Form, which is also equally used by many teachers for conducting, organizing examinations or tests. You may see the screen. In the screen, you are seeing many such e-assessment tools, ICT tools or technology tools. When we talk about ICT or technology tools, you are already aware that it falls under 2 categories. One is the paid category, which is the commercial, which is developed for commercial purposes. On the other side, we have equally good ICT tools or technology tools which are free to use. So one, the proprietary or paid softwares, the other is free softwares or open source softwares. Now in the screen you are seeing some of the paid softwares. They have equally the websites, and some of these softwares have the mobile applications also. So on the left side you are seeing some of the softwares which are paid softwares. On the other side, right side, you are seeing the free websites. As I said, there are application softwares or apps also which we can run on the mobile devices. Some of the popular ICT tools, technology tools or e-assessment tools, we can also say it as online examination or online assessment tools. And some of them are shown on the screen, like Kahoot, QSIS, Mintu, Quizlet, Formative, Mentimeter, Plickers, Socrative. Friends, many of these tools are very popular and extensively used in the teaching learning processes. I would also like to recall you one of the sessions where we have demonstrated and discussed about the Google Form. Google Form is also one of the most popular software for conducting or organizing examinations. I would request you to quickly run through the features or facilities which are available in Google Form and how Google Form is used for creating the tests. As you see on the screen, there are various ways by which you can access the Google Form. One of the ways is through your Gmail account. When you open your Gmail, on the right top side you can see 9 dots. You will click on that. Then when you click on the 9 dots, all the Google applications will come out, will pop out, and you can see the Google Forms in that list. So what you will do, you will click on these forms. This is one of the ways. The second way is you will directly go to the Google and type the website address which is given, like www.google.com/forms/about. So this is another way how you will reach the Google Forms. Once you open the Google Form, then friends, there are various types of exam questions or test questions you can prepare in the Google Form. The types of questions or various formats of questions which you can prepare in Google Form are listed on the screen. It includes short answer, paragraph, multiple choice, check boxes, drop down questions. Even there is facility for uploading the digital files also. Say for example, as a teacher, I am asking my students to develop one project report in any of the text editing softwares. So they can prepare that report. This can be uploaded in the Google Form. So this facility is also available in the Google Form. Then linear scale questions, multiple choice questions, and checkbox grid questions. So all these can be prepared in Google Form. So I would say this is one of the very good tools which you can use for assessing your students digitally. In short, discussed about Google Form. In one of the videos, we have extensively covered that. I would request you to watch that video for getting more understanding about how Google Forms are used for creating tests. Now we will discuss another important ICT tool, which is the Hot Potatoes. We will see, I'll also demonstrate you how this Hot Potatoes are used for developing various types of questions. So Hot Potatoes can also be used for assessing the progress of the students or engaging your students in some assessment activities. So this is one. The second tool which I would like to demonstrate is about the Moodle. As you are aware, Moodle is one of the most popular softwares, LMS software, learning management system. In almost all the learning management system, assessment facilities are available. So we will also see, after completing Hot Potatoes, how Moodle is used for creating tests and examinations.
So friends, as I said, now we will see how these Hot Potatoes can be used for developing, creating tests. What you are seeing on the screen is the screenshot of this Hot Potatoes website. When you access the Hot Potatoes website, this is how it will look like. And how this is accessed? You have to do the normal Google searching, or else you can directly type the website address which is shown in the lower part of this screen, https://hotpot.uvic.ca/. So this you have to type in the address bar, and this will help you to reach the Hot Potatoes website. So let us also understand the different types of questions, the different types of exam questions which you can prepare in the Hot Potatoes. In the Hot Potatoes website, you will see fill in the blanks questions. For fill in the blanks of questions, you can see J clause. So you will see these types of naming, J clause, J mix. This is for jumbled sentence questions. JQs for multiple choice and short answer, and couple of other options are also available. Then JCross for crossword. Then JMatch for matching and ordering questions. So if you want to have match the type of questions, you have to make use of this option. So JCross, JMix, JQs, JCross and JMax. So these facilities are available in the what we say hot potatoes. Now friends, how, as I said, you will access the website using the website address which was given. Then once you open the hot potatoes website, this is how it will look like. You look like, as I said, see, JCross is there, JQs is there, JCross, JMix, JMatch. So these are the different types of questions which you can prepare in hot potatoes. Now after that, you can see on the right side there is something like the masher. So say for example, you have prepared some fill in the blanks questions, some quiz questions, multiple choice, then match the following. So in a question paper, you have this many types of questions. So that will be like look like a single kind of a test paper. Say for example, filling the blanks questions only. If you are using JMatch, match the type of questions only. So that will go as a separate file in the hot potatoes. If you want to merge all these questions, why? Because this is how we do in school settings or higher education settings, where we will have fill in the blanks questions, match the following, short answer and essay type questions. So if you want to prepare the questions in that format, you will make use of this facility, which is the masher. So the masher, this facility, this link is used for combining all the questions that you have prepared in hot potatoes. Now let us see how the questions are created. As you see in the slide, I'll demonstrate a couple of them. JQs, if you want to create like multiple choice questions, then you will click on JQs. When you click on JQs, this is how it will look like. So you will give a title for your quiz, then the question you will type here. Say for example, Google Docs is, so this is a multiple choice question. Google Docs is a kind of a software. So what kind of a software Google Docs is? So I'll give my alternatives here. You can give as many as alternatives here. I have given a couple of them. We'll also see how it is working in the hot potatoes. Then which is the correct answer? So this is a text editor software. So I made a tick mark in this small box. So this is the correct answer. So this is how, in simple ways, how quiz questions, multiple choice questions are created in hot potatoes. Now how you will create fill in the blanks questions? You will click on JCross. This was for match the following. Multiple choice question. JQs was for multiple choice question. And JCross for fill in the blanks question. So you will click on JCross, then this kind of a window will appear. You can give a title, then you will type the question here, and we will see how this is working. Say for example, Google Docs is a text making software. I want my students to answer what kind of a software this is. So I'll just hide this word text. So then the students have to answer Google Docs is a dash making software. So that space the students have to fill. So how this is created, we will see that also. So this is how the fill in the blanks is, fill in the blanks question is created in hot potatoes. As I said, Moodle is nothing but this is a LMS platform, learning management system. So whatever is happening in a traditional face-to-face classroom, everything can be replicated in the virtual space, for that we make use of what we say the learning management system software. So you can have online classrooms, discussions, you can also have examinations in the learning management system. Now we will see how one of the most popular learning management systems, the Moodle, is used for developing e-exams or e-assessment or conducting any technology-based assessment. How we will develop tests or examinations in Moodle. So friends, this is how it will look like if you have a Moodle website. Moodle is a paid software, but they have the free version also, which can be used for a couple of days. This is one of such a free version. Once you create an account in the Moodle website, this is how it will look like. They will give you a ready-made template like Introduction to Moodle. So you can click on this and you can start developing your course or program in the Moodle platform. These are the icons which you will see in the Moodle platform. Moodle platform: home, dashboard, calendar, private files, content blank, my courses. All those are there. Then there is a link for making changes in the website site administration. So this is how it will look like when you access your Moodle platform. Now, as I said, Introduction to Moodle was one of the courses. Introduction to Moodle. So I'll click on Introduction to Moodle now. When you click on that Introduction to Moodle, you will get a couple of other options, of which this is one week one. So normally we, you know, provide courses in week wise format. It can be monthly wise or day wise format also. Normally this is followed week-wise format. So what I'll do, I'll come to week one. There will be introduction and all. Then I'll start with week one. I'll click on week one first. Week one. Once you click on week one, you'll get this kind of a window where add an activity or resource is available. If you want to get this one, on the top right side, there is something like, when you click on this arrow, you can see there is something like to turn editing on. So if you want to make any changes in your Moodle platform, you have to switch it on. You have to keep the editing on. So once you do that, then all these kind of appearances will come out. So what I was saying, usually we give week-wise format. So week one is here. It can go up to 3 weeks, 5 weeks, 10 weeks, 20 weeks, any number as you wish. So this is the week one. You will see the students will see many learning material in week one. Of course, they will also see many other resources like test, Google Form, examinations, then discussion forum, then other websites or open educational resources. All those will be there in the week one. Now we are going to add an activity in the form of a test. For that, what I'll do, I'll click on week one, then I'll click on add an activity or resource. So let us see what will happen when you click on add an activity or resource. When you click on that, you can see a number of facilities options coming out: assignment, attendance, big blue button, chat, all those will come. So if you want to create a test in Moodle platform, you will click on queues. So friends, this is the link or icon where you have to click if you want to develop a test in your Moodle platform. So once you do that, once you click on queues, then the a space for adding your questions, then alternatives, everything will be will be coming in the platform. So this facility you can of course use in Moodle for creating tests. So this is how it is done in Moodle. I would also like to show you how it is done in the Google Classroom. We'll quickly run through Google Classroom. This is how it will look like a Google Classroom. You can see on the top stream, classwork, pupil, grades, everything. If you want to add any test in your Google Classroom, what you will do, you will click on classwork. First, you will click on classwork, then you will click on choose assignment. So this is the place or this is the icon which you have to click to develop what we say test in Google Classroom. Once you click on that, see, this is how it will look like. You have to give the title, instruction you can give. Then since it is a Google product, of course, they make use of the Google Forms. So once you click on quiz assignment, you can see a Google form automatically coming out. So you can click on this Google form and you can keep on adding all your questions which we have seen in the previous video, how a test is developed in Google form. So friends, after that you can use that test for assessing the progress of your student. So this is how the LMS is used for developing tests. I hope you have understood how it is done in LMS and hot potatoes.
So friends, with this we are winding up today's video lecture. In this video lecture, we have extensively discussed about some of the ICT tools. I have also shown how these tools are used for developing various tests. I hope you have understood the ICT tools that we have discussed, and I hope you will use some of these tools for assessing the progress of your children. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video lecture.